What are the top three challenges that governments face in providing a regulatory and legal framework for tokenized assets?
Two of the challenges are similar to ones the government faces with any regulated asset, KYC, and a cost-efficient way of managing taxation. The third challenge is unique to tokenized assets, which is establishing a link between the token and the physical asset. Unless people trust and rely that this link is secure, adoption will never happen.
Should governments focus exclusively on providing that legal and regulatory framework, or should they offer such assets themselves in competition or in collaboration with private industry?
Whether the government should offer an asset is a broader debate, similar to the debate about whether to privatize healthcare or nationalize public rail. The government should at least tokenize those assets which are already its exclusive domain, such as risk-free securities or land titles.
What is the most effective stimulus measure that you are aware of and why? What does the OECD recommend?
You can find dozens or hundreds of plans for every country, and the list is growing from day to day. The most important ones are the ones that are touching three layers: individuals, businesses, and the government bodies that are in charge of working with the issues related to COVID-19. The OECD recommendation, the support is most beneficial when it is transparent, time-limited, proportionate, and non-discriminatory.
So how could tokenization make government stimulus much more effective and efficient?
Using blockchain and tokenization is much faster, and due to the fact that it doesn't require any third parties, like banks, it is much more efficient. But it is best when we need to trace the usage of the support.